us up to his side, and forever we will be his. Singing blessing and honor and glory and power forever to our God. Singing blessing and honor and glory and power forever to our God. Singing blessing and honor and glory and power forever.
sometime, why not now? If we gotta start somewhere, I say here. If we gotta start sometime, I say now. Through the fog, there is hope in the distance. From cathedrals to third world missions, love will fall to the earth like a crashing wave. Tonight's the night.
Every fear. the stars came crashing down in tiny pieces to the ground. I was all alone down here, trapped beneath the atmosphere. Then I thought somebody called my name. I spun around and caught a flame. I gave in to a god I didn't know. All around, but in the distance I could see a flare.
Yeah. Well, how is everybody? Don't you love heat and humidity in Omaha? That's what it's all about. Anything in Omaha. What a great day the Lord has blessed us with. I'm glad it's not raining. And I'm glad that we're here today to achieve that which has been waited for many, many years. I welcome each of you. A few of you were not here this morning, and some may not know who I am. If you don't know me, I'm the lead pastor here. My name is Mark Els. That doesn't really matter a whole lot, but I'm glad that you're here, each of you. What we want to do to start with, we're going to have a group from Mid-America Nazarene University come and sing for us. They're going to sing a song, and then we're going to begin our ceremony of breaking the ground.
We'll be trying to with the wind. We'll see how it goes.
Are you guys on?
Test, test.
Test, test, test.
We good, Lee?
Okay.
Test.
Ready?
I don't think so. Hello? Hello?
No.
Hello?
Yellow.
Hello? Hello?
Technical difficulties. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
You can check. Worst case, me and you can check.
Sure.
Check, check, check. All right.
Nope.
Fine.
You guys sharing then?
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay.
That's cute.
Low down the chariot, let me
hey,
ride.
Hey, Lordy, won't you
low down the chariot, let me
hey,
ride.
Lordy, won't you
low down the chariot, let me ride. Low down the chariot, let me ride.
Why don't you low
down the chariot, let me
hey,
ride.
Hey, Lordy, won't you
low down the chariot, let me ride. Low down the chariot, let me ride. Low down the chariot, let me ride.
Right on!
Right on, King Jesus.
Right on!
Right on, King Jesus. Right on, the conquering King. I wanna go to heaven in the morning.
Right on!
Right on, King Jesus.
Right on!
Right on, King Jesus.
Right on!
Right on, the conquering King. I wanna go to heaven in the morning.
I've been trying so hard just to move.
Do ba do ba do
the way that you want me to. I wanna break free from all the sin inside.
Ba do ba
do 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 do
do do do do
do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do
do do do do
do.
Right on.
Right
on, King Jesus.
Right on.
Right on, King Jesus.
Right on.
Right on, the conquering King. I wanna go to heaven in the morning.
Right on.
Right on, King Jesus.
Right on.
Right on, King Jesus.
Right on.
Right on, the conquering King. I wanna go to heaven in the morning.
Oh, low down the chariot,
let me ride.
Low down the chariot,
let me ride. Low down the chariot, let me ride. Low down the chariot, let me ride.
Oh, low down the chariot,
let me ride.
Low down the chariot,
let me ride. Low down the chariot, let me ride. Low down the chariot, let me ride.
It's a joy to have each of you here. There are some that we want to include especially in our celebration today. I want to introduce to you, first of all, our district superintendent, Pastor Dan Cole. Many of you already know him. He is the superintendent of our Nebraska district. Pastor Cole, I'd like you to come bring greetings.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. This is an exciting time for Southwest Church of the Nazarene, and what a joy for Roxana and I to be here and to share this time with you. Before I share any more greetings, I want Don Davidson to come and stand by me. Would you please, sir? Would you welcome Don today? Many of you were at, a few of you were at our district assembly this past week in Hastings, and the district formally retired three folks, and Don was one of them, but Don wasn't able to be there. And on behalf, Don, of the Board of General Superintendents, I want to present you with your official retirement plaque. And it says on here, Donald R. Davidson, the Board of General Superintendents and your global Nazarene family celebrate your ministry to Christ and the church. You have served faithfully, effectively, and fulfilled God's call upon your life with grace and courage. Your church is grateful for your many sacrifices, and we trust that God's incomparable rewards will be more than compensate for your selfless service. May Jesus Christ, the head of the church, continue to bless you and multiply your ministry in retirement. Congratulations.
Thank you.
God bless you,
Thank
Don.
You.
God bless
Thank
you.
You.
Amen. You're not going to believe this, but I'm not going to be long-winded this afternoon. This is an exciting time in the life of the church to enter into a building project, which is a huge step of faith, but I believe a God-honoring, God-rewarding faith. God will bless your faith. God will bless this great step of faith that you have taken. I believe that with all my heart. And there are great days in store for Southwest Church of the Nazarene here in Omaha. Just keep walking the road of faith and trust and believing that God is able to do exceeding abundantly above anything that we could ever ask or think or even imagine. God bless you, Pastor Mark. God bless you, Southwest Church. We're in your corner. We believe in you, and we want to see you get along. The Lord bless you.
Well, good afternoon. It's a joy to be with you. It used to be called Lincoln First Church. It is now called Connecting Point Church of the Nazarene, your sister city over in Lincoln, Nebraska. On behalf of your Nebraska District Church of the Nazarene Advisory Board, we wish you the very best. Listen to me carefully now. I hope that in just a matter of months, as you begin to occupy the new space, you'll find out that you should have built even bigger. May those classrooms and fellowship hall be filled to overflowing, and may God continue to bless you in your obedience to spread the gospel to those in Omaha and around with the saving message of the Lord Jesus Christ. It is a honor and a privilege for me to introduce to you your mayor. Would you welcome Jim Suttle?
Good afternoon, everyone. You know, last year we had the historic flood for 104 days, because most floods are 2 to 20 days, but for 104 days we outlasted the river and Mother Nature and kept our city safe. And during that process, your two congregations, as well as congregations all across this city, kept praying for me as mayor and for all the crews that were working on this. I'm going to ask your favor again. Will you pray for my wife and I this afternoon? For 5 hours, we're going to be babysitting a 3-year-old and a 1-year-old. I need lots of help. The art of living is the art of giving. And that's what we see here, because you are giving to add to the faith of not only your adults and your teens and your children, but you're adding to the whole community. You're adding to the quality of life that is Omaha, Nebraska. That's what makes us great. That's what's going to make us greater as we go to the future. God bless you.
Well, good afternoon, and I bring you greetings from Dr. David Spittle from Mid-America Nazarene University in Olathe, Kansas. Yeah, let's hear that. Fantastic. And I bring you greetings from the campus there and the cabinet and our Vice President for University Advancement, John North. And I want to say that we are excited to share with you in this church-college relationship. And you've celebrated, Mr. Mayor's here from Omaha and celebrated the local group. And you're also a part of 435 churches in what is considered the North Central Region, Church of the Nazarene. And so I bring you greetings on their behalf as well. And know that you have 770 pastors as a part of that are supporting you. And we just want to say that we're partnering with you in this great endeavor. And we hope to be back with you sometime, maybe in not too far a distant. Maybe it'll be winter time for a great dedication. So thank you so much.
On the back side of the paper that you have, you're going to find an interactive reading. I'd like our district superintendent to come and join me. And we're going to ask you to participate in our commitment to what is about to take place. We've come a long ways. When this church board interviewed me about 10 months ago and told me that they needed to build a building, they also told me we didn't have enough money to do it. And I thought to myself, God's still able to help us. I had heard that it had sort of slowed down the process over a few years. I was hearing wonderful stories of how your former pastor, Willis Kennedy, had tried so hard and yet the dollars weren't coming together. And I applaud him making my job so much easier because he got so much of the groundwork already done. And then when the church board says, here's a plan that we can adopt, we can adapt it, we can make it happen, and the congregation voted with an 85% official vote and almost 90% unofficially, I said, that's an answer to prayer. It was just 2 weeks ago, wasn't it, that I asked you to vote to approve to take out a loan so we can finish this process? And you know, that day we had a 92% approval vote. That's official, folks. I say God's moving in a great way in a very small congregation that's not going to stay small forever. So on the back of our paper, we got a microphone that doesn't like the wind. I know that. But I'm going to ask our district superintendent to help me. And when it says congregation, would you read that part? My wife is going to make sure that you say it loud enough, because if you don't, she's got to say it louder. She's trying to take pictures, though. I know. Let's participate together.
We come today with joy in our hearts to acknowledge that Jesus is the head of the church. It is his church, and we are his people.
His church is universal, timeless, and spread across the nations of our world. Even within our city's context, the church is multicultural, embracing many customs. May we experience real joy of being part of his church.
We assemble here today to celebrate with one another that the Lord of the church has promised a glorious future.
In Jeremiah 29, verse 11, we read, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future."
And in 1 Kings 6, 11 and 12, we read, "The word of the Lord came to Solomon. As for this temple you are building, if you follow my decrees, observe my laws, and keep all of my commands, and obey them, I will fulfill through you the promise I gave to David, your father."
Thank you. Today, as we remember the days of our past when we dreamt of this building, as we consider the needs of our present ministry, as we look forward to even greater ministries in the days and years to come.
Would you stand with me just for a moment, please? With grateful hearts, we come to you this afternoon, Heavenly Father, and we say thank you for who you are and for what you do in our lives. And thank you for this day and everything that it represents. The establishment, the breaking of this ground today, and the building of a new building is about more effective ministry to our community, reaching more people with the message of the good news of Jesus Christ. I pray, Father, that you would bless Pastor Mark and the congregation at Southwest Church of the Nazarene. May they have a great sense and an awareness that you are going ahead of them, preparing the way and clearing the road, and that Jeremiah 29:11 will come really strong and clear to them. I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. They're plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. So today we join our hands together and we join our hearts with you. Help us to have great impact on this community, I pray, in Jesus' name. And we said together, amen. You may be seated.
Amen. We mentioned a moment ago, Pastor Willis Kennedy was the founder of this church. Pastor Kennedy, I believe you started in sometime maybe around the year 1993. And within the next couple of years, while you had no building, you took on a project of purchasing this piece of property. And it took several years to pay for it. It was a sacrifice, and yet this congregation did well. It didn't take 25 years, didn't take 20 years, didn't take 15 years. You paid it off well, sacrificially. It seems only right that the dream that was birthed in Pastor Kennedy's heart could come to the point today where we would give him the privilege of pushing the first spade in the ground. Pastor Kennedy, I'd like you to come and be the first to turn ground for us today. I understand you want somebody to come up and make sure you're doing it right.
This is the one I needed right here. I want to take privilege here. The reason that we have the Southwest Church of the Nazarene is because back in the late 60s, I think it was 1968 and 69, you remember that we had riots, people burning things and this and that. And at that time, the Lord laid it on my heart and a lady by the name of Mary Smith's heart to start a church in Omaha. Now, Omaha has been good to me. I love the city. We moved up here from southeast Nebraska many years ago. Dad came up to work in late 1940s in cut a hay packing house. My first job was carrying the World Herald. I met my wife because she lived on that paper route. And this month, we're going to be married 52 years. I'm saying I like Omaha. That's what I'm saying. I worked for the city of Omaha for 6 years. As a building inspector, and I enjoyed working for the city of Omaha very much, and until it was time for me to retire. So I want to say I love Omaha. I love Omaha and other part of the state too. And I ask you to pray for the mayor, too. Yes. All right. When we move by faith beyond our internal insecurities and external adversaries, we will see God work in life-changing, world-transforming ways. We will repeat the testimony of Jesus that my Father has been working until now, and I have been working. And we will declare with the prophet Jeremiah, Ah, Lord God, behold, you have made the heavens and the earth by your great power and outstretched your arm. There is nothing too hard for God. Remember that. There's nothing too hard for God. I don't care what it is. Boy, I have a wonderful testimony on cancer healing. But it's, I think we've come to this point. We've come to this point, and here's what I said. It's time for us to strap on our tubas. Time for us to strap on our tools. Now, your tools might not be like mine, but it takes a lot of different tools to build a church, okay? And we've come to the point now where it's time to go to work. Physical work. And so I'm strapping on my tools. Where's Jim at? Jim, you know I'm strapping on these tools, and I can use them. I can use them. Another thing I want to say is Nate came to Omaha First Church. Where's Nate at? There he is. Nate came to Omaha First Church and when I was pastor, and believe it or not, I baptized that man all by myself. Isn't that right, Nate? And I asked you to get a scripture when you came. Do you still know it? Okay. Amen. Amen. That was years ago. That was years ago. So that's another reason I love Omaha. Okay, we have to now strap on the tools. Nate, he is a Jewish man, but he loves Christ, and he preaches Christ. And years ago, we had him come to give us a lesson. He went in the building, and he saw the Star of David. How many of you saw that Star of David inside? All right. And he fell in love with that Star of David. And I tried to figure out, and I think I've got it. I think I've got it. It took me a while to do it, but I think I've got it. The people who built this church, they didn't build it for themselves. But I believe from deep in my heart, they built it for the Southwest Church of Nazarene and the Adot Church. Yeah. I believe that. Yeah. I believe that from deep in my heart. Okay, so there we are. Nate and his congregation are wonderful people. It is such a thrill to be a part of everything that has happened at the Southwest Church of the Nazarene. And there's going to be more things happen. And this is just ceremonial. It's going to take a big machine to dig the footings. But this is the way we do it, and I'm going to do it. Thank you, brother. Thank you. Thank you. Right? If you ever saw that, they just give up. I'm going to try to do better. All right, here we go. Oh, look at that.
Rain last night helped.
Yes, it does. I don't know what I'm hitting, but I'm hitting it. Okay. All right, here we go, brothers and sisters. Here we go. All right.
Praise God.
That's
That's the first one.
That's the first one, yeah, and going to be, well, I don't know what else to say except thank all of you. Thank the city of Omaha. I do want to say one more thing. The reason for the name of Southwest here, got to thinking about it. I want it to be Southwest so when people moved into Omaha, they could see it was Southwest Church of the Nazarene, and if they're in that area, then they wouldn't be traveling out to Papillion.
No, brother, that's the church's commemorative shovel. Yeah. I'm going to invite our district superintendent and Pastor Brad Carpenter and Mayor Settle and Kevin Borger to come up and join me for the next round. We want to dig this, and if you're going to take pictures, you got to do it while we do this. Why don't you gentlemen all grab shovels? I'd also like to have all the members of the church board. I need all the members of the church board to come up. Before this afternoon is over, I want to give everyone a chance that is going to support this project, at least with prayers and good wishes, or better. You're going to have a chance, but I want all the members of the church board to come up. If any member of the church board isn't here, they can resign. No, I didn't say that. No, I didn't say that. I'm afraid one of you guys would go sit down if I said that. Who are we missing? I know that we've got some that can't be here. You as a church board have led us in the way. You and members of the board from the last year and years. We had some long deliberations. We had some times when it seemed like we didn't know where we were going to go next. I remember one meeting in particular, this board just simply went to prayer. At the end of our board meeting, we just took time to pray. And I said, I want everybody on the board to pray. We just went around the table. And I believe that that was one of the changes that took place that helped us to come to this place today. And so, board members, I thank you. I thank the ones that are not here today as well. But I invite each of you to put a spade in the ground. You don't have to go as deep as we did, especially if you got ladies' shoes on. I don't care. I just want you to participate. And then we're going to have the Sunday school board come up next. Okay? So we're going to have all the board members go ahead and do this. I thank God for our church board. I thank the Lord that He's given to them wisdom. Sunday school board members, SDMI board members. Brother Chuck, you can turn it again. Hey, you know, if we turn enough of this, we won't need the bulldozers. I think we got a long way to go, though. Sunday school board members. Jim Smith, is he here? I don't see him. Anybody get Jim? There we go. How you doing, Jim? You okay? You make it. At least a little bit. Don't push. The fact that Jim's here with us is almost a miracle in itself. And again, some ladies have nice shoes on. I don't expect you to do deep digging. but I want you to participate. I want you to participate. And may God thank, may the Lord be thanked for what we're doing. Go ahead. That's right. Thank the Lord. That's great. That's great. That's the Sunday School Board. Well, we've still got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 more shovels plus the ones up here. I'd like all of you, if you haven't had a chance and you'd like to, we want you to come up. Again, I don't expect you to have to turn a whole ton of dirt. Maybe you can't even get it all the way in the ground, but I'd like you to come and just press the shovel into it and flip it out a little bit just to say, count me in. If you're not physically able, don't feel bad. You're okay, but we just give you the invitation. If you want to, come up and do it. Kids, you're invited. Children, you're invited. Teenagers, you're invited. Adults, grandparents, you're invited. Let's do it. Mrs. Pastor's wife, it's required. Oh, yes, you did it. That's right.
Pastor Ray said if he turns a shovel, you'll ask for a check.
Yeah. Rav Nate, I want you to be a participant. Yeah. We've still got 4 more shovels, 5 more shovels. Anybody can grab one. We'd like to have you do it. Just stay this, everybody has to stay that way or in front, okay? We've got to have an unruined area for everybody to walk back without falling. There we go. All right. Great. Okay. This is a glorious day, folks. We've waited a long time for this opportunity. Several months ago, it seemed like it couldn't happen. Make sure you get a picture of that, Paula. I praise God for having Dave up here in his chair. Dave's behind this thing. I know he is. Anybody else? Buddy, did you dig? All right. Anybody else? Come on up, Jay, Jackie. Anybody else that wants to? We're not expecting you to turn a lot. Just do it symbolically, saying, I'm in. Careful where you walk.
Yeah, no kidding.
You okay?
Yep.
All right. We're going to move this. You can walk through here. Some of the littler ones work easier. You can use anything you wish. Praise God. Jackie, you're doing great. You're doing great, Jackie. Dave, God bless Dave over there. I appreciate some of these who are seniors that said, count me in. I'm going to be a part of this. Kenny. Hey, Kenny, come on up here and dig a dirt for me. Where's your brothers? I want them to come up and dig a dirt up here. You bet. These guys have just been coming to church for 2 weeks. Second Sunday here. Look at this. I'm proud of them. Ah, Roxana's doing it great. Grab a shovel anywhere you like and just do it. Wonderful. Has there been any children or teenagers that have got overlooked? We don't want them to be overlooked. They're part of the church. Almost got it. Almost got it. There it is. There it is. Yeah. Yeah. Hey, now you got it. There it is. I see it turned. That's great. Anybody else want to? Oh, we got to have you do it. The commemorative shovel's fallen over. Are we okay with this? Yeah. Yeah, anybody else?
Ellie.
Where's Ellie at? All right. We're going to wrap this up. I want the Pioneers to come back and sing for us. No, we're not going to have Pioneers yet. You got to do this right. God bless Sharon. Indeed. There it is. Praise God. Tells me if people in wheelchairs can do this, anybody can do this, I think. Great. I know it's hot. I know it's humid. I thank you for being here. Let's listen to the Pioneers sing one more time. Some more kids? We'll let them do it even while the Pioneers sing. How's that? Hey, kids, did you guys shovel yet?
No.
Grab a shovel. I want you to do it while the guy's singing. Okay?
Take that one. I broke it.
Wow. Whoop.
There you go.
How do I fix it?
Whoever else is going to drop it?
Good. Yeah.
Go ahead. You're starting to do it.
May the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. May the rain fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may he hold you in his hand. May God hold you in the palm of his, hold you in the palm of his hand.
Oh, okay.
Is that good? Lord, let's pray. Lord God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Jacob, we thank you for the blessing you've given us with this project, Lord, and we know that you've blessed it. We just ask you to allow us to get it done in the amount of time that's allotted, that all the funding that's needed is provided, and that all the workers who work on the project are kept safe and healthy. And we just ask that you bless everything that goes on with this project in Jesus' holy name. Yevarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha. Ya'er Adonai panav elecha v'chunechecha. Yisahahaha Adonai panav elecha v'yasim lecha shalom. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace in the name of Jesus, our Messiah. Amen. God bless you all.
Amen. Thank you all for coming out here and being here. This concludes the official part of our ceremony. If you still didn't get a chance to dig and you wanted to, you may. But thank you for being here, and may God bless you. Those of you that are part of the prayer band that usually meets at 5 o'clock, we will not be meeting today. We've already met. VBS decorators, we are still needed inside the building. I will need several men to help us carry chairs inside. Thank you.